गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ऑन द क्रिप्टो सिस्टम, क्रिप्ट एनालिसिस, ब्लॉक साइफर, स्किम साइफर. सो वी स्टार्ट द आवर फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज द क्रिप्टो सिस्टम. बेसिकली क्रिप्टो सिस्टम इज द पार्ट ऑफ द क्रिप्टोग्राफी, और वी कैन से दैट क्रिप्टो सिस्टम इज एन इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ क्रिप्टोग्राफिक टेक्निक एंड देयर अकंपनिंग इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर टू प्रोवाइड इंफॉर्मेशन सिक्योरिटी सर्विस. Crypto system is also referred to as a cipher system because it is convert the plain text into cipher text and cipher text into plain text. The main objective of the simple crypto system is that end of the process only the sender and the receiver will know the plain text. Simple working of the crypto system is that there is a two parties, one is the sender, other is the receiver. The sender encryption system generates ciphertext as output on getting message and encryption key as input, and the receiver end, the decryption system gets ciphertext as input from sender terminal and mixed with the decryption key. After further processing, authorized user at this terminal receive the original message sent by the sender. This is the basic theory of the crypto system. In this diagram also show a interceptor. Interceptor is the third attacker or the third party then can take the plain text into cipher text or cipher text into plain text. We can say that in the whole process there is a chance of attack on the ciphertext. Ciphertext might take lead by interceptor. He may get encryption algorithm as well as decryption algorithm. However, he must be knowing encryption and decryption key to read the message. After this, we will discuss the component of the crypto system. Basically, six components of the crypto system. Number one is the plain text. Plain text is the normal text. It is also called the input text. Number two is the encryption algorithm. Encryption algorithm is mathematical process that produces ciphertext. And the ciphertext is the scrambled version of the plain text. Many algorithms for you convert the plain text into ciphertext. For example, substitution technique and the transposition technique. The decryption algorithm is a mathematical process that produces a unique plain text for any given ciphertext and decryption key. It is a cryptographic algorithm that takes a ciphertext and decryption key as input and output as a plain text. After this, we discuss on the encryption key and the decryption key. Encryption key is the public key or private key, and also decryption key is the public key or the private key. Encryption key is the sender side and the decryption key on the receiver side. The sender encrypt the data using the encryption key, and the receiver decrypt the data using the decryption key. So this is the component of the crypto system. After this, types of the crypto system, basically two types of the crypto system. One is the symmetric key crypto system, other is the asymmetric key crypto system. Number one is the symmetric key crypto system. Symmetric key crypto system basically is the encryption process where same key are used to encrypting and decrypting the information is known as symmetric key encryption. The study of symmetric crypto system is referred to as a symmetric cryptography. Symmetric crypto system also called secret key crypto system. For example, DES algorithm, triple DES algorithm, IDEA algorithm, or Blobfish algorithm use the crypto system encryption technique. There are some features of the symmetric encryption. Number one, person using the symmetric encryption must share a common key. Means the sender side and the receiver side using the same key. Number two, key are recommended to be changed regularly to prevent any attack on the system. Means key change time to time for prevent from the attack. Number three, a robust mechanism needs to exchange the key between the communicating party. The key required to be changed regularly. This mechanism become expensive and cumbersome. Number four, in a group of n people, to enable two-party communication between any two persons, the number of key required for a group in n into n minus 1 by 2. Suppose the n is 2, so the 2 into 2 minus 1 divided by 2 is equals to 1. So the communication requires the one key. The length of key is the short and smaller, so the processing of fast encryption and decryption in symmetric key is very fast. The processing power of computer system required to run symmetric algorithm is less. The diagram show the symmetric key encryption where sender and receiver using the shared key. This is the symmetric key. After this, some challenges of the symmetric key encryption system. There is two challenges. One is the key establishment and the is the trust issue. Key establishment means create a key for sender and the receiver. Before any communication, both sender and receiver need to agree on a symmetric key. It requires a secure establishment mechanism in place. The second is the trust issue. Since sender and the receiver use the same symmetric key, there is an implicit requirement that the sender and receiver trust each other. For example, it may happen that the receiver has lost the key to an attacker and sender is not informed. So this the basic two challenge. The two challenges are highly risk training for modern day communication. Today, people need to exchange information with non-familiar and non-trusted parties. For example, a communication between online seller and customer, such as Amazon and Flipkart. After asymmetric key, the number two is the after symmetric key, number two is the asymmetric key encryption. Asymmetric key encryption is the process where the sender and receiver use the two keys. One is the private key, other is the public key. Concept of public key comes into picture, encryption and decryption of the information. Some features of the asymmetric key encryption. In this, number one, every user in this system needs to have a pair of dissimilar key, private key and a public key. These keys are mathematically related. When one key is used for encryption, the other can decrypt the ciphertext back to the original plain text. For example, our email ID or phone number is the public key and our password is the private key. Number two, it requires to put the public key in public repository and private key is as a well-guarded secret. This scheme of encryption also called public key encryption. Number three, public and private key of the user are related. It is computationally not feasible to find one from another. This is the strength of this scheme. Length of key in this scheme is very large in the compared to symmetric key encryption. So the execution of this algorithm takes much more time compared to symmetric key encryption. And the processing power of computer system required to run asymmetric algorithm is higher. This diagram shows the public key and private key, where the sender or host one collect the private key or public key, and where the host also decrypt the message using the private key. So this is the basic idea of the asymmetric key encryption and the symmetric key encryption. After this, we discuss the crypt analysis. Basically, crypt analysis is the decryption process. In the crypt analysis, the decryption and analysis of the code, cipher, or encrypted text. Decryption process is the reverse of the encryption process. It is the part of the cryptology. Crypt analysis also used during the design of the new cryptographic techniques to test their security strength. There is some attacks in the crypt analysis. Number one, no plain text analysis means the attacker knows the some plain text of the input data. So attacker decrypt cipher text with known partial plain text. Number two is the chosen plain text analysis. Attacker uses cipher text that match arbitrarily selected plain text via the same algorithm technique. Means the attacker use the encryption algorithm or decryption algorithm that is used by the sender or the receiver. Number three, COA. COA is called the cipher text only analysis. Means attacker uses known cipher text collection. Means the attacker use the collection of cipher text that is used in the many other algorithms. Number four, man in the middle attack. This is also called MIM or MIPM attack. Attacks occur when two parties use message or key sharing for communication via channel that appears secure but is actually compromised. Attacker employ this attack for the interception of message that pass through the communication channel. Hash function prevent MIPM attacks. And the last is the adaptive chosen plain text attack. This is called the ACPA. Similar to the CPA, this attack use chosen plain text and cipher text based on data learned from the past encryptions. So this is the crypto analysis attack. The next topic is the cryptology. Cryptology is the combination of the cryptography and the crypto analysis that is study in the previous slides. After this, we discuss the block cipher and the stream cipher. Number one, first is the block cipher. The block cipher, the plain binary text is processed in its block or the group of bits at a time. A block of plain text bits is selected. A series of operations is performed on this block to generate a block of cipher text bits. The number of bits in a block is fixed. So for example, DS and AES have the block size 64 and the 128 bits. Second is the stream cipher. The stream cipher is processed a single bit or a single byte at a time. One bit of plain text is taken and a series of operation is performed on it to generate one bit of cipher text. Technically, stream cipher are block ciphers with a block size of one bit. The diagram show the block cipher and the stream cipher. Finally, compare the block cipher and the stream cipher. The block cipher, number one, the block cipher convert the plain text into cipher text using a block at a time, and the stream cipher using one byte of plain text at a time. Number two, block cipher uses 64 bit or more than 64 bit, while the stream cipher uses 8 bits. Number three, the complexity of block cipher is simple, while the stream cipher is more complex. Number four, block cipher uses confusion as well as diffusion, while the stream cipher uses only confusion. Number five, in block cipher, reverse encrypted text bits are, where in stream cipher, reverse encrypted text is very easy. And the last difference is the example of block cipher and the stream cipher. ECB and CBC are the block cipher example. That is the electronic code book and the cipher book chaining. And the stream cipher example are the CFB and the OFB. CFB is the cipher feedback, and the OFB is the output feedback. So this is the basic difference between the block cipher and the stream cipher. So in this lecture, we have discussed the crypto system, crypto analysis, cryptology, block cipher, and the stream cipher. Remaining topics and the next unit study we will discuss in the next lecture. Thank you.